In this video, we will learn what dependency injection is, why to use it in Drupal, what are the benefits of it, and how to use it in Drupal. So, dependency injection is a design pattern in which the client class, this client class receives the object it needs, called as the dependencies from the service class, another class called as service class. So, service class will pass on those dependencies client class needs through a class called as intermediate, called as injector class. So in this way, client class will only focus on its logic and does not care how the dependencies must be instantiated. This responsibility is taken care by another class called a service class. So this makes the code loosely coupled, and also classes are independent of its dependencies. The advantage of dependency is that again it is decoupled, and since client class is not defining those dependencies in its logic, so it is not hard coded and hence can be reused by passing those dependencies. So it gives us the reusable code. And since the code is reusable and is not binding those dependencies in its logic, this client class is not binding to dependencies in its logic, so it is easy to unit test. Then again, objects are created outside of the class. And the fifth, which is very important here, is it is the preferred way of accessing services in Drupal in classes. So suppose if I want to access a service for getting the current user information, what I would do, I would search, and I would see that I can use this method to get the user information, but it is not recommended to use or call directly those services. Instead, we should implement those services with dependency injection for the sake of reusability and decoupled nature. How it is implemented in Drupal? In Drupal, in order to implement dependency injection, we must define two methods in the class. First one is the constructor and second one is the create method. The constructor method is to tell Drupal that this class called as Drupal Hex controller, I have a controller here where I have implemented and I'm using this current user dependency, which I could use from this simple method. I'm using this service through dependency injection in this controller. So for this we have to use two methods called as construct and create. The construct method tells Drupal that this class needs one parameter called as, one object called as account of this account interface in order to function. So this is a dependency. Now in order to pass that dependency, as in order to pass, play the role of the service class, here comes this create method. This create method is a factory method. What it does, it simply uses this container and creates the object of respective service through this static binding. So here comes three complex words. First is factory method, second is static binding, and this class. So factory method is another design pattern which is a bit complex. So what it does, it create, we just pass on the requirements we want and it gives us the object of those requirements. So here I'm passing a argument as this service. So what it is doing, it is creating a class or sorry, it is creating an object of this class and passing here. So this through this setting binding. So through this late setting binding, I'll get the object of this service called as current user. This is the wholesome how dependency injection works in Drupal. But one more minute, if you guys want to drop, you can drop. One thing in deep is, I've explored that how at the behind the curtain how it is implemented in Drupal. In Drupal, whenever we so in controller we have to extend this controller base in order to create a full functioning controller. So whenever we extend this controller base, let me show you. This controller base implements this container injection interface, and this container injection interface is actually nothing but the injector class, which is injecting the objects passed from here to this client class. So how it is doing that? It is an interface which is declaring this create method, and this create method will, when we will define that create method in the class, this create method will create a class with these, I mean in an object with of this service or whatever the service we would pass in this static binding function. So this is how it works through container injection interface, which is being implemented here by controller base, and hence we implement it, extend it in our controller. So wrapping up the video, in order to implement dependency injection in Drupal, we must use two functions. First is constructor and second is create. Constructor is to tell Drupal what all dependencies we need, and create, the factory method, is to create the object of those dependencies through this late static binding. I hope it is a bit clear to you guys. Thank you.